animals can hurt us, right? Bees and wasps, they can sting.
And polar bears.
Some people are allergic to bee stings and have to get medical attention. What would that mean? They'd have to see a what?
Doctor
if they got stung. So, but insects are also very helpful. I want you to turn to your partners and think of a way that animals can hurt us. And then tell them something that the animal can help. So the purpose of this activity is that kids all have an opportunity to talk and share, and that you're not interrupting the whole class.
That's not helping.
We already did chickens. What's another animal?
Butterflies.
Only if they talk a lot.
They're pollinators, right?
Actually,
think of another. What's an animal? What's an animal that we eat? Turkeys and chickens. They give us what?
Food.
All right. Have a turn to share?
Yes.
All right. I want someone who did not get to share from their group last time, one person from each group who didn't get to share last time, raise your hand this time. One person from your group should be sharing. One person from your group. So who didn't share last time? Miles. How would a snake hurt us?
Because it's poisonous.
There are poisonous snakes. If they bite humans, it can be very deadly. Yes. Bees. What can bees do?
Sting.
Can bees help us?
No.
How do they help us?
With honey.
With honey. Sophia, what did you guys share?
A wolf.
A wolf. How can wolves hurt us?
They can
try to eat us. Yeah, wolves can bite.
An Arctic fox.
Are they good? Are they helpful or can they hurt us?
They can do both.
They can do both. Emerson.
A wasp.
A wasp. They can...
Wait, how are bees and wasps different?
They're different animals.
Oh.
Ava, one thing from your group?
A lynx.
A lynx. How can lynx hurt us?
They can bite.
How are they helpful?
They can provide food. They can get you food.
They provide food to certain groups of people, right? Do they provide food to us?
No.